scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from San Antonio, Texas, weighing in at 227 pounds, the Heartbreak Kid.
Alright, welcome back. This is the episode after the King of Ring pay-per-view. With a bit of fallout. So Shawn Michaels is officially the leader of the NWO now. Look at him rocking that hat. He got quite a bit upset in the back because he got eliminated in the first round of the King of the Ring tournament to Eddie Guerrero. And he wanted a bit of Latino heat, but Eddie Guerrero not available today. He's going after who actually won. Sorry, going after the man who actually won the King of the Ring tournament. I don't know what Kevin Nash is doing out there. Looks pretty cool with that attire, doesn't he? Right, we've got a bit of RVD Shawn Michaels action.
Guys, I know we're all excited when we saw those initials on the card tonight. RVD.
RVD is on freaking fire at the moment. He pinned Brock Lesnar too to become the King of the Ring winner.
Anyone who watches RVD is certainly in for a show tonight. The whole damn show.
Ah! And with Shawn Michaels, there is something in him that drives him to prove people wrong. Drives him to gain respect, even though he's already regarded as one of the best performers ever.
HBK is a proud competitor, and maybe he's just tired of being seen as one of the best ever. Maybe he wants the top of the mountain all to himself.
Shawn Michaels' offense comprises of so many forms of attack.
Corey, yeah, pretty wild stuff here. Shawn Michaels versus King of the Ring went off. Raw opening this up.
Look no further than the source of Shawn's first retirement. Target is surgically repaired back. Attack it, and that may keep Michaels at bay.
Yeah, Shawn Michaels, embarrassingly lost to Eddie Guerrero. So he's pretty mad. Couldn't have the NWO at ringside. What's this? Ooh. Hurting those educated feet of RVD.
No, he kicks out. He's still in this.
Yeah, kicked out pretty easily there.
Looking for a high risk move.
Van Damme needs to get up.
Up high.
Ooh.
He misses the target. Short flight, but a rough look. Both arms trapped.
RVD going for a crucifix. The ref wants to get down. thanks, ref.
I think this match was close to over.
What was that?
And Michaels unable.
Yeah, but we haven't seen much of the NWO. Shawn with a great... Ah, damn it, he's got me with those balls again. Oh, shit. That was a huge move. Yeah, I missed that legend difficulty. Yeah, it makes it pretty hard to kick out sometimes. Come here. Oh.
Did you think that this superstar would be able to get back into this
Come on, Van Damme.
Absolutely not. No way.
Here we go. A bit of rolling thunder. On the Heartbreak Kid. Van Damme to the top rope. Oh, he hits it. Hit the whole damn thing.
Van Damme is just about to finish this.
Ooh. The number one contender, RVD. Thought he had Shawn Michaels there. Oh, and a nice moonsault combination. God damn. RVD's still probably a bit sore. Had three matches at the King of the Ring last night. Oh, and by last night, I mean last episode.
And he's running away.
I wouldn't say that. He's just recomposing himself.
He'll head to the ring.
What the hell's Scott Hall doing in there? Yeah, but Shawn Michaels can get this win. That'd be huge for him. Like, he's been struggling. And so has the whole NWO lately. Oh! Could not counter that at all. Can RVD kick out? Oh my god, he did. RVD is the king of these kickouts.
Adrenaline right now, and you have to wonder what else Michaels needs to do here tonight to secure a win.
Oh, nice. RVD going for that pin. Apparently,
still in it. What a gutsy performance.
What's he doing here? Oh my god, on the back of the neck. That wasn't pretty. Oh, and a nice standing moonsault by RVD. Just put HBK.
This is where great cardio makes all the difference, helping you stay alive deep into the match.
All right, Van Damme.
Put into the corner now. Boom!
Van Damme doing it.
No.
Is he going coast to coast?
What on earth is...
We haven't seen this.
What are they trying to do? I think we know exactly what. Gonna take a trip.
Holy crap.
RVD ending this fight right there.
That was pretty loose.
Oh man, you can see he is feeling it now.
And then they did the taunt and then the pin. One, two, unbelievable. RVD is freaking on fire. The King RVD.
Here. I agree, it was quite the display tonight. Hey, it could have been worse for HBK. At least he didn't lose his smile.
God, HBK's gonna lose his smile if you're not careful, man. This guy cannot buy a victory. But RVD cannot buy a loss, if that makes any sense. Very interesting. We're on to the next match. Actually, a bit interesting. We got William Regal versus Triple H, who is the new Undisputed Champion. William Regal actually put away Goldberg in a steel cage at the King of the Ring, because Goldberg decided to jump off the cage. So, yeah, we'll see who wins this one.
A class is in session. A man who has held countless championships in his career, a truly all-time great of the grappling game. It's gonna be good. WWE Universe, it's time to play the game. Make no mistake about it, the King of Kings is here. It's all about the game. And his opponent from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 255 pounds. The WWE Undisputed Champion, The King! He spent his entire career accumulating power, like a master chess player from DX to Evolution to the Authority, now behind the scenes in WWE and NXT. Triple H looks at every match as a threat to his power. And that's what keeps his motivation so strong. That's
look at that, Triple H. After beating Stone Cold pretty easily, he took one stunner. But now Stone Cold went down. Gotta love that Triple H chant. Triple H.
It sounds so fake. He's settled quite nicely into his role as CEO of WWE, but every once in a while he gets the itch to lace up the boots.
Here we go. Yeah, so William Regal had a pretty brutal steel cage match. Goldberg busted him open pretty good. Took a couple jackhammers. Regal got pretty lucky that Goldberg decided to jump off the thin cage.
Is a big one.
Yeah, but he is facing William Regal and Corey Ike.
First up.
So you gotta wonder if Triple H. Okay. Triple H, the former leader of the NWO, was watching
so much RVD. Inflicted.
I don't know, take apart like his former group. Oh, but he didn't really take part of the former group. Was the leader, Shawn Michaels, though.
And look at this now. Yes, applying the submission hold.
This is no game.
Oh, Regal.
Right now he's looking for any way to break out of this, and he does.
I'm pretty sure, yeah, Regal tapped out Goldberg, I'm pretty sure. Or it might have been a pin. Can't even remember. I remember Edge tapped out Booker T. Oh, what the hell?
Sure we do, the more the merrier.
These two had a fantastic matchup. But where is he?
What the hell's RVD doing?
Such a decorated superstar, Hall of Fame career has accomplished.
RVD's had some issues with Regal.
How do you take down someone as a
And he's the number one contender for Triple H at SummerSlam.
Great difficulty. But the one thing to remember is that due in large part to all that success you just mentioned, Cole, Triple H can get overconfident.
Yeah, they put Regal in the front seat there. Oh, Triple H with a great counter.
So be alert, be ready. Here's the snapmare.
Nice knee by Regal. There's no evolution here on Raw because they are actually all SmackDown superstars. I guess Randy Orton could have been ringside because he's the IC champion and the IC belt's on. Oh, damn! Knee strike out of nowhere. Damn, yeah, Triple H is like, oof. Oh, you avoid the Regal stretch.
Triple H finally able to slow that incoming offense.
That could be the trigger for Triple H.
Oh, the double A spine buster.
If you were still struggling to figure out what exactly
Triple H going for the pedigree, surely. If he hits this, Regal's in trouble.
Pedigree. Regal went down in a heap. Two count. Oh, he kicked out.
Oh, damn, Regal. Yeah, Regal's got a lot of heart in him,
eh?
Kicked out a lot of moves that Goldberg delivered to him, which normally would have been a finish. Oh, Regal with a takedown. It'd be huge if Regal can defeat the new Undisputed Champion.
His plan here.
Regal doing some technical wrestling outside. He's working on the arm, so if he gets him in that Regal stretch, the place will be in trouble.
Producing a trampling.
Oh, off the damn ring post.
Into the ring post.
Yeah, we'll have to see if it's going to be Triple H versus RVD at SummerSlam. At the moment it is, but Triple H will be defending that Undisputed title at Vengeance. As we'll find out on SmackDown in the next episode.
Is
this match going to end in a countout? Nah, it doesn't seem like it. Triple H was probably better off doing another move there.
Look at him. Pride and poise personified.
Ooh, suck it. Oh, what's Regal doing?
Regal here.
Went high, went low.
Yeah, Triple H let overconfidence get in the way of his game plan, and now he's paying the price for that false sense of
security.
Triple
H definitely was overconfident there.
Now's the time to find that second win. Find that rush of adrenaline to push you forward.
Oh, he's going for the stretch. If Triple H taps here, oh my goodness. Is he gonna tap? He's pulling freaking pretty hard.
He's trying to fight it the best he can.
He let it go.
Oh wow, yeah, Regal actually had to let it go. I don't think he had enough. Is that gonna be enough to pin? And it is. Are you serious? Wow. Regal's on a bit of a run here. Just pinned the WWE champion.
Oh, man, I would not want to be in the boardroom with Triple H after a loss like this.
Yeah, he beat the game. I don't know what the deal was. Like, maybe, I don't know. RVD definitely wanted to distract the game, and he did. Well done to William Regal. In the main event of Raw, we have a rematch. Goldberg, yeah, he's pretty salty. He jumped off the cage at King of the Ring and pretty much cost himself the match. But he wants to take revenge on the man that beat him to qualify to get into the King of the Ring tournament, and that is Jeff Hardy.
Big matchup here tonight, ready to go. And I'm looking from behind.
Oh, what the hell's Regal doing?
Ruin this thing. It's a message sent. A message that needed to be sent. Yeah, that guy should be suspended or fined. This is ridiculous.
Suspended, yeah, maybe.
Crazy. He's just doing what he needed to do.
Goldberg already hurt from the cage match. Just got attacked by the man who just beat Triple H.
He's not ready. This man Goldberg is destroying the competition in WWE.
Interesting. Jeff Hardy was on a bit of a run until he got beat by RVD in the semi.
And he plans on accomplishing it through intimidation and
brute force. Oh, no, money was in the first round actually. But it could have went either way. Like Jeff Hardy was really close to winning that match.
Lifts up the shoulder. He needs to deal more damage before trying that again.
So yeah, William Regal, man, he's pushing. He's taken out Goldberg. He's just beat Triple H.
Suplex.
Jeff's stuck again.
And Jeff Hardy heads up the turnbuckle.
We'll have to see on SmackDown because Regal might have made himself number one contender. Like, he really should be a number one contender if you beat the champion.
Slam,
oh, slammed by Goldberg.
Jeff Hardy is,
yeah, we'll have to see what happens
air,
on SmackDown because
what else do you think will be the difference maker for the charismatic and
because I was going to make
Jeff
a number one contender because it was going
to
be a SmackDown superstar because
aggression.
RVD
Hardy
was already number
Based
one contender
on
for SmackDown
right now,
and he is a Raw superstar.
Kick to the gut.
Is this Jeff
here's the setup.
The powerbomb. Interesting powerbomb.
Oh, no. A big splash.
Yeah, if Jeff Hardy wins this match, he definitely owes an assist to William Regal, who he has had some problems with. Like, William Regal made Jeff Hardy tap not that long ago.
From the middle rope.
Another splash. And another.
Crushing them with the splash.
And he's pinning this time.
Off into the pin. Strong kick out there. Gotta change something up with the pin technique.
Yeah, Goldberg is kicking out of these moves, Jeff. Gonna have to do something else, bud.
That didn't go as Hardy
Jeff
pictured.
Ooh, Goldberg evaded the drop kick. Belly to belly.
Able to reverse. All soon.
What the hell's this? Jeff Hardy doing the Endicon device.
Tap out coming. Kneeing his way out. And he's free.
There's a nice escape by Goldberg.
Punch connects.
And a great punch. Damn, that was some impact.
That's just a sample of Goldberg's ridiculous power and intent.
Goldberg definitely
setting
up the jackhammer.
We're gonna see it. We're gonna see that.
Oh, we're not gonna see it. That was a clutch counter by Jeff.
Uh-oh, this is not going to end well.
Oh, another power bomb. I've never seen Jeff hit so many power bombs in a match before.
Here, folks.
Jeff Hardy's going for that Swanton bomb. Oh, nothing but knees.
And this might not have a pleasant ending.
What the hell is Goldberg doing? He's gonna. He might have been throwing Jeff outside.
Oh, mounting and now just hammered away with the rights. Elbows right to the.
Oh damn! You're smacking him right in the face with those elbows. Goldberg definitely not happy. Made it look like a punk. Like a punk by Regal. Jeff Hardy made it look like a punk. Another loss by Goldberg here. Like, terrible for his ego. Oh, twist of fate. Jeff Hardy crawls to the pin. Jeff Hardy nearly beat Goldberg again. He's going for the Swanton. And Goldberg counter again. No, he couldn't get it that time. Is that it? Jeff Hardy gonna win this match? And he does. The assist from William Regal attacking Goldberg at the start of the match. Very nice, Jeff. Yeah, so we've had the fallout on the King of the Ring tournament, the King of the Ring pay-per-view. Jeff Hardy gets another huge win. There's a fair bit going on, man. Well, I hope you liked this episode, and I'll see you next time for SmackDown.